Okay, on today's podcast, I'm going to try something a little bit different for tea time. I am using chocolate milk, and I'm going to try some Burden Blend Orange Matcha heated up in the milk frother. So let's see how this goes.
Maybe I'd be happy to let it all go. Dedicate my life to making jelly molds. Learn to cook and learn to sew. I'm a happy homemaker.
Hi, and welcome to the Comfy Red Couch. My name is Tracy, and I'm your host. And I am coming to you from another gray November Toronto day, where it is starting to get a little bit cold. We've seen some snowflakes falling from the sky, sometimes landing on the ground. We are going into winter, but the happy thought that keeps me going is that in a little less than a month's time, the days are going to start getting longer. And I'm really looking forward to that. And of course, when the days get longer, I'm not sure why. February seems to be a bit colder. You'd think it would get warmer. But that does mean that we are heading into spring, which is probably my favorite season. Even though I do enjoy knitting in fall and winter, spring has got to be my favorite season. Anyway, enough about Toronto, the weather, and my not-so-like of winter. It has been a busy, crazy week around here, as it always has been, but I am excited to share some knitting with you and show you some of the things that I've been getting up to and that I will be getting up to very shortly, and where you can find me. I am Tracy RR on Ravelry, and I am Comfy Red Couch on Instagram. If you are new to the podcast, welcome. This is a podcast primarily about knitting, and I'm always happy to have you come and share the couch with me as I chatter away about some of the lovely things I've been up to this week. If you are a returning viewer, you know I always love having you here, and welcome back. I know that while I was making my matcha, you were off getting your requisite cup of whatever it is you're drinking, and you have your project of choice. You are ready to grab your spot on the couch and just have a nice restful time as I show you all the lovely things that I've been working on, or what I can show you of the lovely things that I've been working on this week. So there are a couple of test knits that are secret, but I can talk about the yarn. And then of course, I do have a finished object, and I have a half finished object to share with you as well. So let's start off with some tea time. And I am drinking out of my mine mug. And I have made some matcha, which is very, very far down there because I'm using a milk frother. And if you overfill the milk frother, you'll have milk all over the counter. So I don't put too much in. And I'm kind of experimenting a little bit with this today. So as you saw before the credits, or before the opening, I have some chocolate milk and I am mixing it with Burden Blend Orange Matcha. And it smells really good. So I love chocolate orange. I was trying to figure out which of my matches to try, so I thought chocolate milk and orange would be good. I was debating the mermaid matcha, but the mermaid matcha is a really strange color, and I wasn't sure what my drink might look like. Not like I see it anyway, because it's in a mug, but those were my two main choices. I went with orange. So now that I have my requisite cup of tea and I've made orange matcha chocolate milk, I think we are ready to say cheers to the week behind, cheers to the week ahead, cheers to all that Christmas knitting that you'll be getting up to if you celebrate Christmas, and all of the winter goals that you have, whether it's knitting sweaters, knitting more socks. Cheers to that. I'm a little bit afraid. It's interesting, definitely interesting. Very, very green tasting for sure. I'll finish it though, I will. Anyway, time to move on to show you my favorite things. Today on the Comfy Red Couch, I am sharing all testnet projects. And the first one I'm going to share with you was living in this cute little robin bag. And this is this week's knit vent. And these are the winter sleep socks. I did share the yarn with you last week, and I used Hedgerow Yarns. And this is the Winterberries colorway in DK. And I also used this little tiny mini. There was 20 grams in this mini. And now that I'm finished, there is an arm length, which I shared last week in a spoiler of the yarn. So not much yarn left over in my mini, although I do still have about 27 grams of this. So if you're looking for just a medium pair of socks, which is what I knit, 100 grams of DK should do you. If you're going to a large size, you may want to have a mini just to, although you might only do either heels and toes or cuffs and toes, whichever you prefer, so that you have enough yarn. And if you're small, well, you should be really good and have extra yarn. So that's the yarn that I used for the winter sleep socks. And the winter sleep socks themselves, I have one on a blocker. And the other one I have kept loose because I've got a different sock pattern on, or a different sock that I've finished on the other blocker. So this is the winter sleep sock. It has a lovely cuff. For some reason I was thinking I had done the cuff in the mini as well, but I haven't. So, if you have a large foot, you may want to either choose to do the toe or the heel if you have an accent color, or definitely make sure you've got enough of maybe another color, whatever. Not sure how you're going to do the large. I don't know that you would have enough. Anyway, there is this gorgeous pattern. I was calling these streams. They're sort of little patterns of two, and then there's a little bit of a separation, then another pattern of two. So I was calling the eyelets streams as I was chatting away about Helen about the design, because I had a question about it. So these were like streams to me. So pretty eyelets, and it has a heel flap there and turn. And it has the slip stitches. Now, one thing, and I've never really talked about this on the podcast, but it is something I generally do, is I slip my slip stitches knit-wise, and that's to actually tighten them a little bit. I know normally you would slip them purl-wise, but in my heels, I always just tighten them that little bit, and that was something I had talked with Kate Atherley about, I guess at one of my sock workshops, whether it was okay to do that. She said actually what it will do is just tighten up your heel a bit and maybe give it a bit more of a reinforcement. So that is something I do is I do slip them. I slip the first one purl wise and then I knit, and then the rest of the slips in the slipped stitch heel I do knit wise. And I did follow the toe exactly, so it is bit of a rounded toe with Kitchener stitch at the edging, and I really enjoyed using the two colors. So this was a nice, really quick knit. I believe I started one evening on one sock, finished it the next evening with maybe a tiny bit of time at work to work on it, but not much. At work I'm usually working other than at the very beginning of the day and sometimes during lunch. And then the second sock came off the needles really quickly as well. So winter sleep socks, nice, squishy, definitely will be warm. These are actually going to be a gift for someone, so I will be getting those ready to give away. And just happy to say that I'm thrilled with how they've turned out, and oh my goodness, this yarn, the Winterberries by Jane of Hedgerow, just knit up so, so beautifully. The next pattern I'm going to talk to you about, and the next project, I guess, is in my lovely Snoopy bag and my Charlie Brown and the Halloween, the Great Pumpkin Charlie Brown. And this is using my yarn from Tracy of Nora George Yarns. This is the Hogwarts High Inquisitor. This yarn was very, very difficult to see with this pattern, and I did make a few mistakes where I had to tink back a few times with the few different things in the test. I still have one more sock to knit. These are going to be a gift for my lovely coworker Rosario. And I've talked about Rosario on the podcast before. He often comes and sits with me in the morning before our day begins at work. And he was the one who last year during Vlogmas, as I was hanging the Christmas balls outside on the tree, or the bulbs as I call them, he drove by and then the next morning said, "I saw you hanging your balls on the tree." So I love Rosario, but Rosario's been off work for about a month now, just after our Canadian Thanksgiving, and he had his hip replaced. So he's had hip replacement surgery, and I wanted to make something for him for that. But at this point, he's only had one hip done, and I've only got one sock done. And this one was a challenge for sure with the dark, dark yarn. And so I'm thinking that Rosario might have to have the other hip done before he gets the second sock, because with this one, I am going to admit to having some second sock syndrome. But it does have, and it's so hard to tell, a lovely design in it. I do wonder if it's a bit lacy for a man because there are eyelets in there, but I'm sure Rosario will love them, even if they are a little bit lacy. But Tracy's yarn knitted up in such an interesting way, and I had originally called this project Not My Nemesis because I am making them for a friend, but as I was knitting, I said they look like a swirling nemesis, so these are now called my swirling nemesis socks because the yarn colors just swirl. So I do have a second sock. This was a test knit. I needed to have one sock off the needles by the 24th of November. I did make that deadline. I had it off, I think, on the 22nd, and then took a couple of pictures the night of the 23rd. And then yesterday morning, I took a couple of better pictures. I also put a post on Instagram with a bit of a risque theme to it because, of course, with Rosario having his hip operation, H-O, half-finished object, H-O, I put a silly little message for him. Anyway, this is one done, and the second one will actually not be started until I have everything else that is on the comfy red couch done, off the needles, and then I will pick up the second sock and this yarn again. Oh my goodness, it is dark, so really hard to pick up some of those stitches sometimes, but turned out so, so fun. I do have a close-up on Instagram, and you can see the patterning a little bit, but yes, with the dark yarn, you don't see the nemesis pattern as well as you would if you used just a plain one, but that's also some of the fun of test knitting. I think Rosario is going to love these, and that's really the point. So my Nora George yarns, love, love, love. And there is the Great Pumpkin Charlie Brown to go away for a little bit, but will come out in December so that I can get those done for Rosario. The next thing on my couch, we are going to go into, spoiler alert, because I'm going to share some yarn with you. And this is the yarn for the final project for KnitVent. So this is KnitVent 6. And that will be released on the last Thursday of November. So today is the 25th, that'll be Monday, 29th. I think the 29th of November is Thursday. I'll put the proper date down there. And this is living in my lovely So Sweet Violet bag. Now, I've actually already done one of KnitVent 6, and I am now working on a second one. And I am doubling yarns. So I am using Cascade Ecological Wool, and this is in the natural colorway. I am pulling from the outside and I am pulling from the center to make a chunkier wool. And I am also holding it double with something so amazing, which is also being held double. So I have to be really careful with all of my yarns because I'm now holding four strands of yarn together. So this is Hedgerow Yarns, and this is Jane's Fluff Base. Now this was a yarn, when it first came into the house, I shared it with you. And I'll have to put a photograph of what it looked like before I skeined it up because it looks very, very different now. But look at all of the fluff. After I finished the first project, I was starting to have my ball of fluff cave in a little bit. It was collapsing in on itself. So I wound it up again and it really fluffed up even more than it had been before. But oh, those colors in there are amazing. And held double with the natural ivory. It comes out really nicely. And there's pinks, purples, greens, pops of red. It's just such a fun mohair to hold double with this. And I cannot wait to share this project with you next week. So as I said, I've already completed one. The eco is huge, so I do have enough to definitely finish two. I'm getting a little bit nervous about whether I will have enough of the fluff. However, my first project, I had one extra round more than I was supposed to. So I'm hoping that I don't have two not perfect test knits. I do have one not perfect test knit already done with that one extra round. I really want this one to be perfect. So I'm not sure if I'll have enough yarn. If I don't, I don't. You'll get the gist of it. It will be a beautiful project. I believe that I am going to gift both of the projects made from this, but I'm not 100% sure. But anyway, that will be released this Thursday, and I'm looking forward to finishing that. I've got about 10 more rows to go, and then I will be finished Knit Vent 2018. So it has been a great collection. I've been wearing my Dust of Snow wrap a lot. My lovely niece Violet, we were out yesterday at a birthday party, and I was wearing it, and she looked and held it and said, "Oh, shiny." Yes, it was, and she might try and steal that one from me. I'm a little bit nervous, but it's really, really big, so she wouldn't be able to carry it off too easily because it is so large, and she's only 5, so, you know, if she were to try and carry it away, I'd probably see her trying to take off, and it's so shiny that, you know, it's like the shiny thing in the ocean. The fish go after it because, of course, it's shiny. Anyway, I don't think she's going to steal that one, but I will talk a little bit more about our event yesterday, and I gave her a project for her birthday as well. Next thing on the needles, and this one is on the needles, and again, we're still in spoiler alert. This is the Handmade Sock Society project, and I did share the yarn with you last week, and I am loving how this is knitting up. So I am using Twig, which is a mini that came with the Elm Tree Yarns skein of yarn that I am using as my main color. So this is my contrasting color. And I am also using Blackbird Nest. And I cannot tell you how gorgeous this project is. I'm so happy when I'm knitting on it. Made a little bit of a mistake yesterday, which was good because it caught a little omission in the pattern that's being tested right now. So that was good. So I had to tink back a little bit, and that was okay. But I didn't get much knitting done yesterday. But oh my goodness, these two colors together are glorious. This will be released not Monday as in tomorrow, but the following Monday. So I will see you on the podcast next Sunday, more than likely. I'm thinking about that one still. But the Monday, the day after, I will be sharing this. The reason I say I'm thinking about that is because I am debating on whether to do Vlogmas again. I really enjoyed doing Vlogmas last year, but to do Vlogmas and a full podcast every week is just way, way too much. And my word of the year is self-kindness, so I do need to be, you know, taking care of my health as well. So I'm trying to debate whether I do a full podcast each week or whether I do Vlogmas. You see a little bit of everything every day. And of course, when there's a pattern released, you get to see it that day, that night, the next day, whenever you watch the podcast. So you don't have to wait a full week because, of course, this will be released on a Monday and you would have to wait. I mean, you'll see the Instagram pictures and the Ravelry pictures if you're looking, but you would have to wait a whole week for the podcast. So there is something nice about Vlogmas and that whole instant gratification. So I may, because of course this will be released in December, I may just do this as a Vlogmas. We shall see. But it is living in this lovely bird bag, also by Fat Squirrel. I have the two bird bags, winter birds. They're fun, they're bright, beautiful project bags, but just, I'm hoping maybe the winter birds will help bring spring. Anyway, the final project I am going to share with you, I am allowed to share, so let's say we're in a half spoiler alert. So, hi Scout, do you want to come up? I've got all project bags at the spot, at the wrong spot. I do. Scout has come to share the final project with you, and this is a very, very special project. I think I'm actually out of spoiler alert now, because I do have permission to share some of the details about this project. So it is a test knit. It is going to be a fabulous test knit. And if this is Big Scout sitting on the couch, because Scout is a large dog, inside my little bobbin bag is the yarn for the next little bobbin pattern. So Danny of Little Bobbins is going to be coming out with a pattern in time for the Christmas Eve cast on this year. So this is in my gorgeous, gorgeous Christmas Eve cast on bag from 2 years ago, I believe it was. And this was a kit that I was lucky enough to get because I did test knit the first pattern, the sock pattern that Helen came out with for the Christmas Eve cast on. So maybe it was 3 years ago. I think it might have been 3 years ago now. So this is definitely a very, very interesting project that I'm going to share with you. So I'm not sure what the release date will be, but of course it will be ready in time for you to cast on Christmas Eve. And I have known the yarn that I was going to use for this since the moment I saw the swatches that Danny had made. And I am using this gorgeous skein of Black Lodge. And this is one of my amazing Viola sock yarns. And this is actually, I believe, my first sock yarn that I got from Viola, from Emily, and I won this. So a few years ago, I entered a knit along, and Emily was hosting a knit along that you had to have a finished object that was done in Viola yarns, and it had to be in, I think, by October 31st or November 1st, one or the other, and the prize was a skein of yarn. And this is what I won. So I am finally going to use this and knit it up. And like I said, as soon as I saw the pattern, I knew I wanted to use this gorgeous skein. Now there's going to be a highlight color as well. And it's not going to use as much yarn, but I am seriously considering adding a little bit of this gorgeous Nora George yarns. This is Fur on Gold Sparkle. And oh my goodness, holding this up against the screen, it's not a maybe anymore. This has got to be a reality. A, I can't wait for you to see this pattern once it's released, but Oh my goodness, I cannot wait to knit these socks. So today I am going to wind me some yarn. I will be winding the full skein of this. I'm not sure. I think I'm just going to take just as much as I need off of this skein of fur rather than, sounds awful, this skein of fur, F-I-R, not F-U-R, skein of fur. Anyway, I think I might just try and take the amount I need and leave the rest so that I can make a project on its own because, oh my, look at that glitter and look at that green. Tracy did a good job with this. So, how exciting is this? I've talked about this on the podcast before. My two favorite yarn dyers, Emily Viola Yarn and Tracy's Nora George Yarns. I get to work with my two favorite yarns. Oh, in this amazing project bag. So, I'm excited to get it wound up, cast on, get them knit up, and I'm not sure what the release date will be, but oh my goodness, this has been a hard secret to keep. It's been hard to, I'm glad that I was allowed to come out of spoiler alert to share that this will be coming out sometime in December, and as I said, definitely before the 24th. This bag, I've had a lavender sachet in it, and it's been stored waiting for another lovely project to go in it. It smells so good. Anyway, this was a joint kit a couple of years ago. So Danny made the bags. Jane of Hedgerow Yarns did a gorgeous fairy lights colorway, and Helen did the sock design, and those were the fairy lights socks. So anyway, I'm so excited about this test knit. Anyway, that is all I have to share with you on my favorite things, and I think that's actually quite a lot, so I'm quite proud of myself. One thing I forgot to tell you at the top of my favorite things was as soon as tea time was over, I finished it off because a cold match is never very good. And I really wasn't a fan of the chocolate milk and orange matcha. So I just wanted to down it quickly. I need some, I think there's caffeine in matcha. It's supposed to be like an even keel caffeine. But right now I'm feeling, maybe it's the socks, maybe it's the matcha, but I'm feeling a little bit giddy. It's probably the socks. Anyway, that, I forgot to share that with you. Mine is all done. It is now time for some brown paper packages, and I got some lovely things in the mail this week. And an interesting thing happened where my sister-in-law put a package in the mail 3 weeks ago for Greg. We are still having the Canada Post rotating strikes, although from what I understand, they are being legislated back to work. I will not add my political comment there. You can probably, anyway, so my sister-in-law put an expedited parcel in the mail for Greg 3 weeks ago. We got it Friday. I ordered my case from France. It was finally put in the mail about a week and a half ago in France, and I had it early this week. So St. Catharines to Toronto, France to Toronto, expedited. I don't think expedited. It's been a bit crazy with Canada Post, but I was just happy to get some things in the mail. So first off, I'm going to share with you, and I called these my balls of confusion. I ordered some lovely pom-poms, and I ordered 7. There are only 6 here now because I did put one on my How Quiet hat that I gifted to my sister-in-law yesterday. So these are faux fur pom-poms from Holy Cowl. And I was confused because I had to figure out which one I wanted to use on my sister-in-law's cowl. And then I'm looking for the skein of yarn. This is the skein of yarn I want to make my own hat with. And I then have to figure out which color I want to use for my pom-pom, whether I want. So, balls of confusion. So these, as I said, are from Holy Cow. They are a company based in London, Ontario. So very close, a couple hours drive away. And this one here is the White Fox pom-pom. This is a 4-inch pom-pom, and they are all labeled. So this is good for me, for sure. And I ordered, I showed you this blue one here. This is the Bluebird 5-inch pom-pom, and it is fluffy, fluffy. Oh, I'll use this one for the other side. This one, oh my gosh, it is fun. I really want a pink one, by the way. This is the Purple Husky, and it's a 5-inch, but I was just sort of thinking, wouldn't it be fun to sort of do like Mickey Mouse ears with my pom-poms? They are fluffy and soft. Oh my goodness, love them. And I also got Gray Fox, a 4-inch. I wasn't sure. I got a variety of 4-inch and 5-inches because I wasn't sure how big they actually would be. But fun, fun faux fur. This white one, oh my gosh, I love it. It's another 5-inch. This is Arctic Fox. And then the final one, and this one was actually seriously considered for my How Quiet hat because it went really, really well with the purple. And this is the Silver Wolf, the 5-inch. The one I ended up choosing was the rabbit fur one. So faux fur, but rabbit. And I decided to go with very neutral colors for the most part. So grays and whites. I had 3 whites. And then, of course, I threw in the 2, oh my gosh, I'm feeling like I should hang these in my car as I'm driving along. You know how you've got them over top of the rear view mirror? That'd be, yeah, just pom-poms hanging in my rear view mirror. And then when I need to pop one on a hat, I can easily do it. Anyway, these balls of confusion are really, really lovely. I will need to order some more. I want a pink one. I already said that. I really, really want a pink one. But oh my goodness, I need to make more hats. I definitely need to make more hats. So that is one of the things that arrived in the mail on Friday night, just in time to be put on the hat that was going to be gifted to my sister-in-law yesterday. So thankfully they arrived on time. The other thing that arrived on Friday, and I'm going to, I'm a little bit funny. And I don't mean funny haha, I mean funny strange. My Knits About Winter finally arrived, and this was mailed from Würzburg. It is a signed copy. There's this gorgeous sticker on the back, right where the opening is. Do I actually want to take this out to show you? I'm sorry to say, no, but I'm gonna share it a little differently. I did open it and I slipped it out and then I slipped it back in, and I'm going to be storing it like this because it did come with the PDF version and it's on the cover on the inside. So I do now have this on my iPad so that I can read it on my iPad rather than, oh, I'm funny with books. I don't like to crack spines on books. I've always been that way. It is a signed copy as well. But yeah, I'm a little bit particular about my books. Now, this leads me to the other thing that arrived in the mail earlier this week. So I will share a little bit more about Knits About Winter in a minute, and that's the book by Emily Foden. And I'm going to be using the Viola yarn that Emily dyed for the Christmas Eve cast on. My new case arrived for my new iPad. So I had an iPad mini. It is 6 years old now. It was well loved. It was in a gray OtterBox and it was very well cared for, but it was starting to run out of memory. It wasn't doing updates anymore because it was quite old. And when we bought the new iPads, I bought one for myself and one for Greg because both of our iPad minis were beyond the date. His was only 32 gigs, at least mine was 64 on the last one. So I had a little bit more room for all of the photos of yarn. I don't have photos of my children, I have photos of yarn. I know I'm not the only one. Anyway, so my iPad came in October, and it had been sitting sealed up waiting for a new case. And normally I would have gone with an OtterBox, but all they had were black OtterBoxes. And Greg got the black OtterBox, but I didn't want to have both of us have a black OtterBox. We might get it confused. I might take the wrong one, you know. And putting a case, a good case, on such an expensive piece of equipment is really, really important, you know, for safety of that device. And I mean, it's with me a lot of times. So I started looking up different cases online, and I came across this one by Norev, and it is leather. Now, my very first iPhone, which I actually don't even have a cell phone anymore, but the 3G, I think it was, yeah, the 3G, before the 3GS, so it's really, really old, and it definitely does not update anymore. I had bought just a leather case to keep it in, and it was the best. It kept it in really great condition. I put a screen protector on it. And I thought, I really liked how the leather case protected my iPhone, and it was just a really nice way to carry my phone. So I decided to go with a leather case for my new iPad. So this is a Norev case, and this is the blue colorway. I have it en français. Blue ciel, so sky blue, and came in this lovely little red pouch, and then my new iPad now has a beautiful case on it, and lots of reminders coming up. I'm loving the fact that I can open my iPad with my finger, and of course I'm not being able to do it now. There we go. Anyway, I said I was going to talk about knits about winter, and I mentioned that I did get the PDF. So the PDF is now on my device. So I can make it bigger so I can read it. I can make it smaller so I can't read it. But anyway, it was a perfect week to get my case for my new iPad, as well as my Knits About Winter. My case also has a little flap here so that you can angle it. This actually cost me less than buying an OtterBox, which is amazing because it had free shipping from France, and it's just beautifully made leather. Anyway, that is, oh my goodness, a very, very indulgent brown paper packages. Balls of Confusion, a beautiful book that, yeah, I don't want to crack the spine on, and my new case. So it was a good week in post, for sure. Anyway, that leaves me with an empty basket for the week. I'm expecting a few packages in the upcoming week. I am still waiting for my Bird and Blend Matcha Advent. I'm starting to get really, really nervous. It was put in the post a while back, and funny how the one from France came really quickly, but the one that's from England and was ordered the day that the Matcha Advents were released still isn't here. But anyway, it'll get here. I've got another tea advent, so I'm not going to be tea-less throughout December. Anyway, that is brown paper packages for this week. It's now time for Bits and Bobs, and this is my segment where I talk about anything and everything that is not necessarily knitting related. And it is getting near the end of November, so of course, for me, we're getting into hibernation time. Come home at the end of the day, curl up on the sofa, turn on the fireplace, do some knitting. But I'll have to say, it's been such a busy week this past week that there's been a couple of nights where I've come home and it's taken me a few hours to really just settle. And if I've been lucky, be able to fit in a few rounds here and there of the socks that I've been working on. And of course, I'm on all these tight deadlines. So that leisure hibernation time isn't really there. Anyway, it has been, as I said, very, very busy, but yesterday we had a really fun Saturday. We were invited to my niece Violet's birthday party. So my sister-in-law, she has her birthday in a couple of days, and my niece, it's actually her birthday today, and my nephew, it was his birthday at the beginning of November. My other nephew, it's his birthday in January. So we usually have a birthday party for close to one of the kids' birthdays, and we celebrate all of their birthdays. So yesterday, we had a fun, really, really girly, it was really good, birthday party. And we made unicorn pictures. So we went to an art studio, and it's called Four Cats Art Studio, I believe, and it's in St. Catharines. And we made unicorns. So I'll put some photographs of some of the things that we did while we were there. And we had a box. We had to paint. We had to choose the color of the background for our box. So we all went with different colors. A lot of people were going to go with purple. And that was actually my first thought, was I wanted to go with purple, but then I decided to look and see what Isaac and Nathaniel were doing, because I wanted to see if we could maybe, since there were going to be three of us making these art pieces and they're all very similar, I wanted to make sure that they looked a little bit different. So I looked, and Nathaniel was just using the straight blue, and it's a gorgeous blue. Isaac had decided he was going to go purple, so I decided that I was going to then do something not blue, not purple, and I love both of those colors. Blue is my favorite color, but knitting, I seem to like pink and purple. So, purple was taken, I went with pink. But everybody was doing some different colors, and my brother-in-law did his in this gorgeous green. My sister-in-law, she did hers in just the flat pink, and my brother-in-law's mother was also there, and she did hers in a gorgeous purple. So I decided to take a little bit of a risk, and I added a bit of, and you're not going to believe this if you've watched the podcast before, I added a bit of yellow to my pink, just a little bit of yellow to make orange. And I wanted just a tiny bit so that it would be more of like a corally pink rather than a scary yellowy orange. And oh my goodness, I was about to ask for a little bit more yellow, but then it all got blended in together, and it is perfect pink. So I will put a photo of my perfect pink unicorn. And Isaac's was really, really neat. He decided to go for a swirled effect. So he did do purple, but he didn't do a flat purple right across. He's got like a really, almost like a magical Harry Potter-esque, you know, swirling potions, the pensive sort of idea. And his is really, really interesting. And Nathaniel, he used the flat blue, and it looks great. So we're going to have three unicorns. We didn't get to bring our unicorn art home with us yesterday because they need to pour a resin on top to make it all stay. So there's glitter in there, there's paper, there's all sorts of different things. That's how you get the unicorns the same as you use a cutout unicorn, and then you cut out the shiny paper that goes on the mane. The only problem with mine was I didn't realize you were supposed to draw the eye on the unicorn before you put the glitter down. I got a little bit glitter happy and forgot to put the eye down. So she did say I can put the eye on after the resin is dried. I can draw an eye at the top. So I think I'm going to try and do that. You just use a Sharpie. But my unicorn has cute little heart glitters, or little heart-shaped confetti on the unicorn body. And so when I get it back, I did ask if there was a possibility that she could draw the eye, because she drew really good eyes, because of course that's what she does for a living. She makes unicorns all day long. Not just unicorns, other things too. Anyway, we will be getting those in a couple of weeks, and I'm really excited to share those with you on the podcast. But we had such a fun day. And after we left the art studio, we went out for lunch. We all enjoyed a lunch together at Swiss Chalet. And I think I talked about Swiss Chalet a couple of weeks ago. It is the Canadian chicken favorite. It's a rotisserie chicken place, and you get to sit down. It's a restaurant, and it's sort of, I like to call it the McDonald's of chicken, but it's not really McDonald's at all. It's more of a, it's a little bit more upscale than McDonald's, but, you know, there's definitely not, you know, nice linen tablecloths. But Swiss Chalet, it's a Canadian favorite. I love the sauce, and their fries are always good too. But it's the festive special time, so you get some Lindt chocolates as part of your order if you do get the festive special. So Isaac and I both had the festive special, and Nathaniel got the kids meal. Anyway, we had a lovely lunch, and then after lunch, we went and visited my mother-in-law, and then after that, we all went to a local, I guess it's a hotel that my sister-in-law has a membership at, and the kids went swimming, so we got to use the hotel pool, and of course, the adults stayed on deck. I did a little bit of knitting on my Handmade Sock Society project, and the kids had a great time swimming and playing in the water. And it didn't end there. I mean, it was a long day. St. Catharines is about 2 hours from Toronto, so an hour and a half on in good traffic. So I left early in the morning to get down there for the art appointment and the art party. Not an appointment, it was a party. And after we left swimming, we started driving home. There was a bit of a traffic jam because Toronto traffic, there's always a traffic jam somewhere. And we stopped at the mall. Nathaniel and Isaac had purchased some Lego for their cousins, for the boy cousins, for their birthdays. And Isaac really liked the Grindelwald carriage that they had bought one of their cousins. So he wanted to go to the Lego store on the way home to buy himself a set. So we did do that. I may have also bought a few things. Some Blush, some Davids. Yes. Isaac also bought some more of the minifigs. So he likes these Lego minifigures. I think I shared with you quite a few weeks ago. I know I shared with you the Harry Potter and... doesn't look like it's in here anymore. His invisibility cloak. Oh, there it is there. The invisibility cloak. And so yesterday, I think Isaac got a Ron, which was with a rat. He had been really hoping to get Voldemort, which he got. And he also... he got Draco Malfoy the day before. And I believe he got Dumbledore with the pensieve. Although I could be confused because Friday night he bought himself a couple of minifigs and he got Draco. And that's actually when I think he got this one here, the Dumbledore. He got another one. But he was very, very happy because he was trying to get the ones that... was feeling them all, trying to make sure he got the one that he really, really wanted. So, Ron, he could, Voldemort, and maybe it was Mad-Eye Moody. I can't remember. Anyway, that was what Isaac really, really wanted to get yesterday. And he did. When we got home from our long, long day, it's awful. I can't remember what I did. And I'm pretty sure it did not involve knitting. So I came home and I think I must have sat on the couch for a couple of hours and I didn't do a stitch. I think I did some social media stuff, uploading my unicorn pictures onto Instagram because I just love them so much. Isaac sent me those. But yeah, I didn't get any knitting done last night, which is crazy for me. Tiny bit earlier in the day, but yeah, no knitting last night. Anyway, I am really, really hoping to get some good progress done on my Handmade Sock Society socks in the next couple of days. It would be really great to get those off the needles by Wednesday so that I can put the Christmas Eve cast on. Of course, I do need to finish my second project for the last knit vent, which will be released on Thursday. And then I will be putting another Nemesis sock on. And yes, black yarn with a pattern called Nemesis. Probably not the smartest thing to pair together. Anyway, I think that, yeah, Saturday was a big day, and the rest of the week pales in comparison because Saturday was such a good day. So I think that's all I've got to share on Bits and Bobs this week. And wow, yeah, I can't even remember what I did last night. It was just such a good day yesterday. Thank you so much for joining me on the Comfy Red Couch this week. I hope that you've had a chance to sit down and give that project that you've been working on some of the attention you've been wanting to pay to it. I am wishing you a wonderful knitty week ahead. And oh my goodness, we are coming up on December, which means that if you have an advent calendar, you'll be able to start opening those windows very, very soon. I did mention last week that I am planning on knitting another Dust of Snow wrap. And I'm really looking forward to opening those doors one by one and knitting each section of the Dust of Snow wrap day by day. So that'll be a really relaxing way to knit that super, super big wrap. Anyway, I wish you a wonderful week ahead, and I look forward to seeing you next week. I did say that I am contemplating doing Vlogmas. I've already done KnitVent. And if I do decide to do Vlogmas 2018, I will not do a regular podcast. I might do what I did last year, which is I'll sit down to do a mini podcast on the Sunday and just maybe go through some of the things that I wasn't able to share with you during the week. But otherwise, it just takes up way too much time to do a Vlogmas each day and the podcast. And December, as everybody knows, is a crazy, crazy busy month. So we will see what happens next week. I will see you one way or the other. In the meantime, have a lovely week ahead. Bye. I'm not sure I'll do that again. No, not going to do that again. Really not going to do that again. Chocolate milk and matcha. No. Yeah, not so good.